Problem 7 is asking us to find the exact value of the remaining trig functions of theta when cosine of theta is negative 1/3 and theta is greater than pi over 2 and less than pi. This tells us that pi over 2 is less than theta and theta is less than pi. Tells us that we are working in quadrant 2. That's going to help us determine that sine is positive, cosine is negative, tangent's negative. So knowing that cosine of theta is negative 1/3, we can draw a right triangle, identify theta, and label our adjacent and hypotenuse as negative 1 over 3, because cosine of theta is adjacent over hypotenuse. That means that we can use the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, to find our remaining side. Plugging in negative 1 squared plus b squared equals 3 squared, we solve and get 1 plus b squared equals 9, b squared equals 8, so b equals plus or minus the square root of 8, which actually simplifies to 2 root 2. Now that we've found our remaining side, which is our opposite, we can start using that information to find our remaining trig values. Most straightforward would be finding our secant, because it's taking our cosine and flipping it upside down. So that would give us 3 over negative 1, which simplifies to negative 3. Next, we can find our sine of theta, which is 2 root 2 over 3. Since we are working in quadrant 2, we know our sine is positive. Our cosecant is taking that value and flipping it upside down, so 3 over 2 root 2. When we see this, we have a radical in the denominator, so we need to rationalize it, which gives us 3 root 2 over 2, and the 2 root 2's times each other is 2, so 2 times 2 is 4. Next, we can find our tangent. Tangent of theta is y over x, or opposite over adjacent, so 2 root 2 over negative 1 just gives us negative 2 root 2. Our cotangent is the reciprocal of that, so negative 1 over 2 root 2. Have to rationalize with that square root of 2, so we get negative root 2 over 4.